Hello everyone, welcome to the channel Academy of Fine Learning. This particular tutorial video will see that how classes and objects are implemented in Java. We know already that these two are the very important features of each and every object-oriented programming languages, including Java. And definitely, these two are classes and objects are two very core features of Java. So the objective of the video is that after watching this particular video, we'll learn about the detailed explanation of classes and objects, and we'll see the practical program-wise explanation for these two concepts of classes and objects. So before I go through the Eclipse screen sharing mode and execute the programs and make you understand, let's learn the basics of these two concepts. So what is a class actually? A class is nothing but a blueprint of an object. So whenever the question comes to your from the interviewer side or from the exam side, when you're in school or in college, please give this answer that a class is a blueprint of an object, and an object is an instance of a class. What do you mean by these two terms? To explain these two terms, we can see this particular building and its blueprint over here. As you can see that there is a building provided over here, correct? So this building is like object in Java. That is, while running a Java program, actually in memory the object is created. And this particular building design, this architectural design, is actually can be explained as a class in Java. That is, this is the blueprint. Okay, this class is an example of this building design, which is the blueprint for creating this particular building. But from this particular blueprint, we can create n number of buildings. Similarly, from a particular class, n number of Java objects can be created. And the objects are real, and it actually occupies the memory, and it's actually requires when we execute a Java program. The entire Java program is based on the concepts of classes and objects. So an object is what? An instance which is created from the class based on the features of the class. And a classes is nothing but blueprint of an object. Yes? So now we'll see that an object have basically a object. Each and every object in Java generally has two things. One is the state, another is the behavior. Yes, the state and behavior both are required, both are obtained from the class based on which the objects are going to be created. There is the instance of the class is an object, and object gets from its class the state and behavior. In simple term, and state is what the object knows, so the variables which is defined inside a class, those are the things which the Java objects knows. Behavior is the object actually does. Behavior is what the object which the Java objects actually does on a particular program. Yeah, the methods are defined in the class, and these methods are used by the Java objects, and then it is known as the behavior of that particular object, the way it called the methods of the class. So that's the theoretical part. We'll not go through the theoretical more. Rather, we'll see that now how these things can be implemented in Java program. So this particular thing, so in this screen sharing, I hope that you can see my screen over here, and you can see that a particular class is created. The name of the class is classes and objects. The class is created based on this particular syntax, class. Then open the curly bracket and close the curly bracket. Then it becomes a class. So this class is harmless and it's of no use, because it doesn't have a main method. Yes, now in this particular class, if we put something like public static void main, then it's becoming worthful, because the program execution starts from the main method. If you don't have a main method in a particular program, then the program cannot be started. Now in this example, we'll see that how to create an object and how it gets the values and the state and the behavior from the class. Now we'll give some integer variable. Integer a is equals to 10. Okay, and we give another integer variable. B is equals to, will not initialize the value, and another integer value will give. Or you can give like this result. Yes. Now, in the public static void main, we can create the object of the class which can get this behavior of the class. Okay, state of the object, correct? These variables can be used as the state of the objects. Now we want to put some behavior for the object. Could you put something like void add up? Going to add something. Return these two values. So we'll add this a and b values. We'll put result and b equals to b. Before we put the values of a plus b, we can give some values to b. Will be better. So 10 plus 20. So output should be 30. That's what our motto is. If we call this, then we'll get the value results. The results has to be printed, right? So system dot out ln. Summation result is give this plus result. That's what we get. Now we'll create an object of the class. How to create an object of the class? You have to give the class name first. Give the class name here. Then the name of the object. You can give the obj1. If you give semicolon over here, it will not throw in compile time error because it will be taken as the reference of the class. Yes, so this obj1 is taken as the reference of the class named classes and objects. Now we want to create the object means you have to give the you have to use the new operator new and then again use the default use the class name and use its default constructor. If you don't know about the default constructor, please look at my video on the constructors and constructor overloading both. We will go in detail by using this sign. What you are doing basically, we are going to create a object name obj. How we are going to create the object obj? By using the new operator. The new operator is used for creating the object obj by calling the default constructor, which will be available automatically in the Java program by the Java compiler. JVM will do it automatically for you. So now this object ob1, it has what? Has the state of integer a is equals to 10, b is equals to nothing, and here result is equals to nothing. Means it will be initialized to 0 by default because integer variables are initialized to 0 by default, correct? And then it has the behavior of void add up. So the object can do add of a and b and can display the result through the line number 10. Yes. So the object knows a, b and result variables, and object does adding up the a and b variable and store into the result variable and can display that. Now we can even change the values over here. Okay, we'll not do all those things. I'll make it simple. We can instead of using these two lines to create an object, we can use a single line. So basically you go over here and this line is sufficient for creating object. So in one chance, in one line, we are creating object. We are not going to create a reference first, and by using the reference we are not going to create the object. Rather, in a single line we are creating object. This is the most widely used technique. Okay, so always keep in mind that we are creating the object in this way. Now we'll use this object obj1 dot call this method addUp method. We call the addUp method, execute run, set the thing has come. Have run method and the result has come. Summation result is 30. This line is executed now. Yes, because this line is inside the addUp method. AddUp method is called by the object of the class, classes and object, and it's possible because inside the classes and objects class, this method is defined. Then you can change the variable's value. For example, obj1 dot a, and you can change the value from 100 to from what? Obj1 dot a. You are changing the value from 10 to 100 now. Let's see now, if we call that, what will happen? Call the method obj1.addUp. Now, the value of a has been changed to 100. So, 100 plus 20. 120 should display. The first result should be 30 and the next result should be 120. Coming, as we expected. These are classes and objects. Okay. Even we can create the object of a class from outside of the class. Let's see how. We'll create another class. Class load. in fact, read all the things which you have done over here. From here, our motto is what? To show that we can get the object of a class from the body of another class. Here we'll do the same thing, that is create the, okay, if we create, now you see that here the error is coming, correct? Because this add up method is defined into the body of the class hello. It is not inside the body of class classes and objects. So obj1 is an object of the class classes and objects, so it cannot call the method add up. It doesn't know that where the add up is actually. You cannot use this method, this object obj1, to call this method. Same way, you can see that this is also showing an error. So the other class objects cannot be used to modify the variables or call the methods of another class. Only the same class object can be used to call the variables and the methods of that particular class. So I'll create the obj1 as an object of the hello class. Now there is no error over here, correct? There is all the errors has gone up from here. Correct, right? See this here. So basically all changes only the class low. Yes. Yes, now without any error, the same output we got. Because we have just used the object of the class hello and not classes and objects. Then we can have the access of void add up and have the access of these variables. Okay, we can restrict that also. Okay, keep one thing in mind. If we make it private, we can make restriction. See over here, now it's not letting us to modify that. The field hello.a is not visible. By default, the Java's access modifier is default. Okay, so for the default access modifier, we can use the variables inside the same program, outside the class also. In case of protected also, it can be used. In case of public also, it can be used. In case of private, it can only be used by the objects inside the same class. So that's what's the conceptual difference between them. When I'll go through the object access modifiers and all, that time it will be all clear to you. So for the time being, I hope that you understood the concept of classes and objects from this particular class. And then we can run up this program and we can see at the end that it's working well. Yes, because we have removed the private from here. So this is the classes and objects concept in Java. I hope that you enjoyed the session. You understood the classes and objects concepts in Java. For any queries, you can put into the comment section. I will give you answers. And please don't forget to subscribe the channel and like my videos. Thank you. Thank you very much.